work more and more and
हाँ
at low wages. So if we want to, so if we, if so everyone, as earlier Vikram said, we are aware of what we have to, we are always aware from beginning that what these jobs are going to give us. So if we think that, if we are not agree with that, then we should not go for it. And if we are going for it, then we should be aware that we have to work in high hours. We have to work for very much. We have to work highly with low wages. But it is ultimately, it is going to help us with our skills. That's all from my side.
Okay, good. Next person is Mohammed Mohtakib Alam. Mohammed Mohtakib Alam. Mohammed Mohtakib. Yes. Mohammed Mohtakib Alam. Yes, I can hear you. You're audible. Yes, you're audible. You did not appear for the assessment last week, so today it's your turn, so kindly speak on the topic which was allotted to you. Oh, topic for Group B. You were in Group B, Mohtakib.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Ma'am, my name, hello everyone. My name is Mohammed Mohtakib Alam, and I am from ECE, Electronics and Communication Engineering. And our topic is corporate is a slavery or not. Ma'am, I think corporate is not a slavery. Slavery is an evil practice. So, very centuries ago. But I don't like to give this time and the job timing are 10 hours and so beginner cannot develop too much because everyone wants their life to grow. And if anyone is then is zero because we will assign a task and our is spend on that thing. So I think corporate job is not so much good, and I can say the two main tasks put a bad effect on our health too, because many our relatives told me continuously sitting on the chair make very difficulties on them. They have very health issues like stomach problem, eye problem, etc., etc. And they suggested me, if you want to be a part of corporate sector, then you have to care of yourself too much. This thing, it is okay with me.
Okay. From Group C, Arvind Kumar Thakur. Group C, Arvind Kumar Thakur. Arvind Kumar Thakur. I think Arvind Kumar Thakur is absent for this week as well. Okay, Moshumi, I will give you certain names, okay? Ask these students to personally write to me about the reason why aren't they attending the classes. Last week also, these students did not attend the class. This week also, the same thing. Take down the names, Moshumi. One is
ma'am.
Ajay Kumar Shaw.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Arindam Patro.
Where were you, Arindam Patro? I called out your name.
Ma'am, there was mic problem. Ma'am, my working this time. That's why I am
okay,
not
then
answering.
Arindam, you please start with your speech. I want to listen to you. Start with your speech. Okay. You are in Group A, Arindam. start with it. Yes, you're there. Arindam, are you there? Again, I think there is some technical error from your end. Okay, but Moshumi, take down these names. Ajoy Kumar Shaw. Ajoy Kumar Shaw. Ankita Sinha. Ankita Sinha. And Arvind Kumar Thakur. Take down these three names and ask these people today to formally give me proper reasoning and writing why they're attending the classes.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I Obhinav Sarkar, role 133, and I did not assign in any group.
Yes, because
and
you
my,
were not
it's
present.
My first yes. class.
Yes, I can understand. Apart from Obhinav, I'm sure there might be few more students. Those who do not have a group allotted yet, okay, and were not present in the previous classes, today is your first class. Obhinav, if there is somebody else, you just tell me the name as well, okay? Obhinav, I will place you in group C, okay? You
okay,
are
ma'am.
In group C. Obhinav, what is your full name? Obhinav Sarkar. Is it Obhinav Sarkar? What is your roll number, Obhinav?
Yes, ma'am.
Roll number?
133.
Okay. Obhinav, you are allotted in group C. Okay. Is there
yes,
anybody ma'am. Else apart from Obhinav Sarkar who is attending for the first time today and does not have a group allotted to them? Is there anybody like Obhinav? Okay, if since there is no one as such and rest of your assessments are taken already, which was the first pending assessment, I will start with our discussion topic of discussion today, the theoretical portion, the discussion today, and then again we will get back to the practical denomination. We will get back to the practical performance with the GD portion. So take down, and you are supposed to take down the points or the portions which I will discuss today for your future reference, okay? We will discuss with the types of group discussion. This would be our topic of discussion for today. The topic of discussion for today would be types of group discussion. So you can give the heading as types of group discussion. Before I start with this, I would give you just an overview of what we are going to study today, okay? Initially, let us recapitulate about what are the things that we learned till date, along with our assessment. Till date, we learned about what is meant by group discussion, what is a group discussion, how a group discussion is being conducted, what are the do's and don'ts of group discussion. While we discussed about these areas, we got an idea about a concept where it is said that during a group discussion, unlike a debate, during a group discussion, the main aim of the participants is to achieve a set goal. That means to achieve a proper solution at the end of our discussion. So we should all keep this particular point in mind that in a GD, we are not supposed to argue. In a GD, we are not supposed to contradict. We are not supposed to counterattack our own group members. What we are supposed to do only is to place our views, and while placing our views, we all of us, like for example in group A, group B, group C, all the members respectively based on the topic that they are allotted, their aim is to bring a proper solution at the end of their discussion, discussion presentation. Clear? We also discussed about certain personality traits while we discussed about the concept of what is GD. We talked about that for being a successful orator in a GD, for being a successful presenter, the participants needs to have the interpersonal communication skill. Participants needs to have confidence in speaking. Participant needs to have leadership qualities. Participants needs to have time management skill. Participants should also have reasoning capability so that they can present their topic with proper reasoning. These were the areas that we discussed. Along with that, we also had a practical round where I gave you topics based on current events, based on certain events that we are presently, the world is facing, presently we are also facing, you as an engineer, final year student, almost at the verge of ending your student life and entering your life of professional life. What are the topics which can be important for you? What are the areas that can be important for you? We discussed about that. These are the things that we already discussed. Today we will start with the new portion that is called types of group discussion. So basically, types of group discussion means that how many categories and subcategories of group discussion are there around and how organizations and what kind of topics, what kind of organizations does follow what technique, what style. We are going to discuss that. So write down underneath types of group discussion, there are two broad categories. Underneath types of group discussion, there are two broad categories. Apart from my microphone, rest of your microphones should be mute. Alicia, please mute your microphone. It is, I think by mistakenly you have turned it on. Alicia's microphone is on. Only my, while I am discussing a topic theory wise, only my microphone should be on. Rest of yours should be mute. Okay. When you start with the practical round, you can unmute yourself. So group discussion can be broadly classified into two main categories. Number one, write down method of conduct. And number two, nature of topic. So there are two broad divisions. Number one is nature of conduct. Number two, sorry, method of conduct and nature of topic. These are the two broad divisions. Now we will try to look into the deeper connotation of these broad categories. Write down. Based on method of conduct, group discussion can further be classified into, based on nature of conduct, group discussion can further be classified into the following. Number A. Now, underneath this, you will give A, B, C, D, okay? Number A, structured group discussion. Structured group discussion. Write down. In this type of group discussion, structured group discussion, In this type of group discussion, the topic is given to the participants. In this type of group discussion, topic is given to the participants. By the selectors, topic is given to the participants by the selectors. And a time frame is allotted to complete the discussion. And a time frame is allotted to complete the discussion. Full stop. This is the most commonly followed technique. This is the most commonly followed technique for a group discussion. Full stop. Next, number B is unstructured group discussion. Write down unstructured group discussion. This is number B. Unstructured group discussion. Write down, in this type of group discussion, in this type of group discussion, the topic is given to the participants. The topic is given to the participants. In unstructured group discussion, the selectors, in unstructured group discussion, the selectors do not. In unstructured group discussion, the selectors do not allot any. In unstructured group discussion, the selectors do not allot any specific topic Do not allot any specific topic to the candidates. Any specific topics to the candidates. And the candidates with mutual consent. And the candidates with mutual consent try to select a topic on their own. Full stop. But this method is not a very popular one among the organizations or institutions, among the organizations or institutions, full stop. So till now there are two types of group discussion we have just now learned. Okay. Further, there are divisions. There's some. I repeatedly told you to mute your microphones. Don't you understand this simple thing that you're supposed to keep your microphones mute when the class is going on? Okay, so till now, what we discussed is, we discussed about two basic concepts till now, two basic types of group discussion. There are more types. First, let me explain you the first two, which we discussed. So underneath method of conduct, okay, underneath method of conduct, the group discussion is further subdivided into four different categories. We discussed about two right now. The first category is known as structured group discussion. In a structured group discussion, the group members are given a topic by the selector or the moderator or facilitator or teacher, whoever is conducting the GD. The topic is allotted to them and a time frame is given to them. A time frame is allotted and given to them, stating the time that when they are going to finish the discussion. So what would be the time frame for the participants to finish the discussion? Structured GD is the most commonly used form of group discussion that is predominantly used all across, be it in business schools, be it in institutions, be it in any organization, company, MNCs, all of them follow this structured pattern more commonly. After the structured pattern of GD, after the structured GD, the next type of GD is called unstructured GD. Unstructured GD is nothing but just the opposite of structured GD. In an unstructured group discussion, the facilitator or the moderator or the selector do not give any topic to the participants. The participants or the candidates choose topic on their own. Okay, they take mutual consent, they discuss among their group members, they take mutual consent, and then they choose a topic on their own. Moreover, there is no particular time frame also said. So it is a very unstructured manner and not that popular as well. Okay, so unstructured GD is not a very popular method of group discussion. These are the two things that we discussed. Now, number C, write down, role play. This is another type of group discussion which falls under the category of method of conduct. Third one underneath method of conduct is called role play. Write down, number C is role play. Write down, in this type of group discussion, in this type of group discussion, the candidates are given specific roles to play. The candidates are given specific roles to play in the backdrop of a given situation, in the backdrop of a given situation, full stop, within the framework of their role, within the framework of their role, within the framework of their role, the participants have to solve, the participants have to solve the problems inherent, participants have to solve the problems inherent to the situation given to them. Participants have to solve the problem inherent to the given situation given to them. So what is role play? Role play is something which you already did when you were in second year or in first year. Role play is a concept which you actually already had done. In role play, now previously maybe you were not aware of this fact that role play is also a kind of GD. You only knew that, maybe you only knew that role play is a mode of selection. Yes, it is a mode of selection, but role play falls under the category of group discussion as well. Underneath method of conduct, role play is also another category. In role play, what happens is, in role play, you are given a topic. For example, if I give you a topic called dowry system, and I ask you people to do a role play on dowry system. In that case, what you do is, in normal group discussion, when we do a structured GD, what you people do is, you people prepare your speech and you turn by turn, you speak on that. But in case of role play, you are not turn by turn, you are not speaking or giving your statement based on the topic. What you do is, you frame it in the form of a drama, maybe. You frame it, you stage it. So what you do is, you rather stage the whole topic in the form of a drama, and each one of you take up one character. Character, that means you, each one of you take up one role, and you try to play that, you try to enact that, and through your acting, you basically express your point of view. Because while you are acting, you use dialogues. That dialogues which you are using in a role play are basically the kind of speech that you want to produce. Now, through role play, the evaluators basically evaluate a candidate's creative ability, a candidate's team building ability, a candidate's leadership skill, a candidate's concept of time management, okay, and creativity as well. So these are the areas through role play the candidates are evaluated. Then number D, write down number D, group discussion with a nominated leader. This is the fourth category, group discussion with a nominated leader. Take it down. Generally, no one is nominated as a leader. Generally, no one is nominated as a leader of a group discussion. And all participants are treated as equal. Full stop. But in this type of group discussion, a person is nominated as, a person is nominated as a facilitator or a leader of a group and he may summarize the discussion. And he may summarize the discussion or solutions. He may summarize the discussions or solutions discussed at the end of the group discussion. Full stop. Sometimes the leader is nominated by the group members themselves. Sometimes the leader is nominated by sometimes the leader is nominated by the group members themselves. This was the last point underneath method of conduct. Okay, so what is it saying? It is saying that during group discussion, okay, with a nominated leader, this is basically trying to say this point. Normally, during a group discussion, you know, this idea of selecting someone as the group leader is not that popular. We as moderators or facilitators or selectors, we normally do not prefer the concept of nominating a particular person as the group leader. Why? Because if we nominate someone as the group leader, rest of the students or rest of the participants might not be that proactive, and only the concentration of being proactive, of being more efficiently leader-like, that whole thing will be concentrating on one particular boy or a girl. But through a group discussion, we are actually trying to make everyone a leader. Understood? Through this process of group discussion, our aim is to make everyone, every participant, a leader all by themselves. Every participant should be able to conclude his or her speech on their own. Every participant should be able to speak confidently. Every participant should be able to maintain the proper time span. So there should be a time management skill. So through group discussion, all these things should be inculcated among all the participants, not a particular group leader. But yes, again, there are teams, there are members who normally feel like nominating a particular person as their leader. You can definitely do that. If you want in group A, if somebody wants that in our group, this particular person will be our group leader. That can be done by the participants themselves. But the facilitator does not nominate a leader, normally does not nominate a leader. It is the participants who can nominate their leader. Now, if you have a group leader, then the duty of that group leader is to summarize the total discussion and to present a proper conclusion with a proper solution at the end of the group discussion. That is what a group leader should be doing. So now, till now, we finished the first concept or the first division or the first type of group discussion, which was called method of conduct. Now we will enter to the second type, that is called nature of topic. So underneath nature of topic, what are the subdivisions? We will discuss that now. Write it in this manner. Group discussion can also be categorized. Group discussion can also be categorized based on the topic allotted for the discussion to the participants. Full stop. There are three kinds of topics which are broadly used. There are three kinds of topics which are broadly used in a GD. Number A, controversial topic. write down. Controversial topic. The name itself suggests a lot of things, you know, that like in the name itself, the definition is lying. Controversial, controversy. What does this word signify? The word controversy, the word controversial always signifies to a word where there is a scope of agreement and disagreement. When we are talking about the term controversial or controversy, there is definitely a feeling when we close our eyes and we think about the word controversy, there is definitely what comes to our mind is a concept of one section of people agreeing it, one section of people disagreeing to it. Okay, so the word controversial, topics which are controversial, definitely will be the topics which will be where all the participants might not agree. Okay, so that kind of topics can also be given during a GD. So write down, these are topics which are controversial. These are topics which are controversial and which have the potential, controversial and which have the potential to generate an argument. Which have the potential to generate an argument. Such topics generally make the discussion. Such topics generally make the discussion lively as arguments and counter-arguments are presented. So such topics generally make the discussion lively as arguments and counter-arguments are presented. Full stop. This gives the evaluators more opportunities. This gives the evaluators more opportunities to evaluate the candidates. Full stop. For example, if I give you a topic like how ethical is cloning? This topic is an example of a controversial topic. Okay, how ethical is cloning? Now, one section of the society or one section of IT professionals might agree to it, might say that yes, cloning, why not? Why can't we call it an ethical one? If we are doing it on a legal basis, if we are not breaching any privacy, why can't we do that? So another section will be talking about the negative aspects. But in a group discussion, you cannot do that. It's not a debate. We need to keep this in mind. Even though if it's a controversial topic, we need to keep it in mind that our end result or our end aim is to reach a set target, is to reach a set possible solution. Our aim is to end the discussion with a proper solution to achieve a set goal where all the members would be agreeing to one particular point at the end. You cannot leave it open-ended. You cannot leave it with two contradiction at the end. There should be a proper ending, even if it's a controversial topic. It's not a debate. We need to keep that in mind. Number B, abstract topics. Write down. Number B, abstract topics. Write down. There is a growing trend of assigning abstract topics. There is a growing trend of assigning abstract topics. That is, topics which are vague and unclear. That is, topics which are vague and unclear. Full stop. These topics enable the evaluators to evaluate the creative ability of the candidates. Full stop. Every candidate can have his own interpretation. Every candidate can have his own interpretation of the topic. Full stop. Number C. Now write down case study topics. Number C, case study topics. Case study topics. Write down. Here a situation is provided. Here a situation is provided to the participants, which may depict a problem faced by the organization or the managers. Full stop. Participants need to analyze the situation. And think of various alternatives. To solve the problem full stop this kind of group discussion tests the ability this kind of group discussion tests the ability of the candidate to think of solutions keeping the situational factors and constraints in mind. Now, before I start with the practical presentation or before I start with the practical assessment for your second round and before I give you the topic, I will just explain you the last two topics which I discussed, or rather the last two points which I discussed. Then I will allot you new topics based on what I taught today. Okay, based on that, I will give three different groups will be getting their three different topics. You will be getting 10 minutes time to prepare yourself, and then I will start with your practical presentation. Okay, so the last two topics that we discussed, last two points, are abstract topics and case study topic. What is abstract topic? The word abstract, okay, when we use this word abstract, it means something which is unclear, something which is not clear to us. It is basically, I'm sure all of you have heard this word abstract art. Normally, there are three different types of arts that we can see. One is painting, normal painting, where you see various maybe sceneries are painted, various a beautiful oil painting with a palace and all, some scenic denotations are done. There are also paintings which are like portraits, okay, portraits of a particular person. And there are third categories, abstract art or abstract painting, where you will see the painter on the canvas, he or she has just maybe painted colorful lines. And that on the white canvas, there are few colorful lines, and that is the painting. You will see such paintings in art exhibitions as well. Those paintings are called abstract paintings. Why? Because in abstract art or in abstract painting, basically there is, it's a very vague and unclear topic which is being presented to us. And the creator normally leaves it up to the spectators or to the listeners or to the audience to decipher on their own. So during, when we give abstract topics in GD, we want to see the creativity of the participants. Because when we give abstract topic, since it is not very clear to everyone, different individuals, different participants will give their own point of view to that. Some creative, some different point of view, which will not match with Google, which will not match with your friends, which will not match with your senior or someone. Whatever topic is abstract, you think about it, and whatever you learned till date, whatever ideas you have formed, you use all your gray matter to present those abstract topics. Since the topic is unclear, you try to give your best to make it as clear as possible. That is what is abstract topic. Normally, abstract topics are given. And I'm telling this to you beforehand. Today, I will give you abstract topics only. Okay? Next is case study topic. In case study topics, a particular situation is given. Normally, last week, the first assessment that I had taken, I had given you basically case study topics, where I had given you topics based on MNCs, okay, the crisis, or whether it is slavery or not, those who are working in MNCs, like a topic which is based on a situation, current situation of MNCs, current situation of COVID-19, like what are the current facts and figures and situations, what are the things that we are facing right now. A case is presented and the participants are supposed to scrutinize the case, supposed to put their point of view and present a discussion. Basically, through case study topic, we try to, evaluators try to test the ability of the candidates to think of solutions. That means a problem is given to you. In case study topic, we give you problems. Like I gave you a problem, like is working in MNCs, like is it a slavery or not? Basically, like I gave you a topic like work. I did not give you a question. I just gave you a topic like working in MNCs is a form of slavery. Now, this is a case. Now, all of you gave your own point of view to it, but ultimately your aim was to give a solution. And we basically, through your presentation, tried to analyze how much can you think of a solution to a situational problem. So case study topics are of that category. Clear? So till now, we have discussed about the types of group discussion. And we discussed about two broad types. We discussed about method of conduct. Underneath method of conduct, we discussed about four broad subdivisions: unstructured GD, structured GD, role play, and group discussion through a nominated leader. And then we discussed about nature of topics, where we discussed about topics like case study topic, then abstract topic, and controversial topic. Now I will give topics to individual groups. Listen to this carefully. I will give topics to individual groups and then I will give you 10 minutes time. We will start with the presentation today. I'm sure today we will not have the time to finish it off. Okay, because it's already 2:30 now. So we will not get the time to finish it off. I will continue this assessment next week as well. But today I will give you the topic and I will give you 10 minutes to think, prepare, and then we will start from today itself. Take down the topic. Topic for group A will be, if an alien lands on Earth, which country should he settle in? If an alien lands on Earth, which country should he settle in? This is the topic for group A. Topic for group B. Short prayers reach heaven. Short prayers reach heaven. Topic for group B. Short prayers reach heaven. Topic for group C. Bharat versus India. Topic for group C. Bharat versus India. So did you understand the topics which I had given? Topics, again, I will repeat the topics. Topic for group A, if an alien lands on Earth, which country should he settle in? Topic for group B, short prayers reach heaven. Topic for group C, Bharat versus India. Clear? These are the three topics. I will take the attendance as well. Right now, I will take your attendance also. While I take the attendance, you will get 10 minutes time. After that, I will start with the assessment. Afreen Parveen.
Present, ma'am.
Okay, those who are present, when I take you, call your name, unmute your microphone and respond. Abdul Basit, are you there? Abhrudeep Ghosh. Sorry, Abhishek Kumar Verma.
Yes, ma'am, present.
Okay. Abhrudeep, you already responded.
Yes, ma'am, present.
Okay. Ajay Kumar Shaw is absent. Alisha Hello. Riaz, Ajay Kumar
present,
Shah. Ajay Kumar... Is Ajay Kumar Shah present or absent? Alisha Riaz,
present, ma'am.
Okay. Amrita Adhikari.
Yes, ma'am.
Amrita present, okay. Ankita Sinha is absent. Anumeha Kumari Pandit. Anumeha Kumari Pandit. Arindam Patro.
Nalvia. Please stay.
Yes.
Arindam Patro. Ma'am. Present. Deep Chatterjee.
Yes, ma'am. Present.
Okay. Will I have to repeatedly tell you people to? I unnecessarily unmute. Why are you unnecessarily unmuting your microphone? Only when your attendance is taken, you are supposed to respond. Other than that, you should keep your microphones turned off. Indrajit Kumar. Indrajit Kumar.
Yes, ma'am.
Ayush Kumar.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Vishakha Pandey.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, members of Group B. Ananya Kumari. Ananya Kumari. Ananya Kumari. Bikram Shardar.
Bikram.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Dharmendra Rana.
Yes, ma'am. Hello.
Dharmendra Rana, present? Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Hello, Dharmendra Kumar Rana.
Okay. Divya Suman. Divya Suman.
Yes, ma'am.
Kanak Mandal. Kanak Mandal. Kanak Mandal. Kanchan Chauhan.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Kunal Kaushal. Kunal
Kaushal.
Okay.
Present, ma'am.
Khushtar Hussain.
Khushtar
Hussain.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Labuni Maji.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Madhurima Nandi. Madhurima Nandi. Madhurima Nandi. Manisha Ghosh.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Mohataki Balam. Mohataki Balam. Mohataki.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Bhavya Singh.
Present, ma'am.
Anurag Biswas.
Ma'am, present.
Yes, I heard you. Anurag Biswas. Anurag Biswas. Now, members of Group C. Antarik. Antarik.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Mohammad Nihal. Mohammad Nihal. If I don't hear your response, I will mark you absent. Mohammad Nihal. Shahrukh Arfin.
Yes, ma'am.
Shahrukh Arfin.
Yes, ma'am.
Mohammad Imran. Mohammad Imran. Abid Ali.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Megha Devghoria. Megha. Moshumi Dhar.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Nidhi Kumari.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Nidhi.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Nishant Raj.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Pragati Singh.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Archit Vats. Archit.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Abhishek Kumar Singh.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Drishti Mojumdar. Drishti Mojumdar. Drishti Mojumdar. Obhinav Sarkar.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Hello, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Hello.
Okay. Yes.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, who is this?
I'm Mohataki Balam.
Okay, Mohataki Balam. Why didn't you respond when I called your name?
Ma'am, usse unmute kiya to mera mobile hang kar gaya.
हो ही रहता तो हम मौसमी और मंशा को उसी वक्त मैसेज किए थे मैम.
ओके try to speak in English Mohtakib. This is
your
English classes. You should not speak in Hindi. Or else you will have this habit of speaking in Hindi always. Yes, yes. What happened?
Ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am. Ma'am, I have also missed my attendance, ma'am. Ma'am, my phone got hanged. Ma'am, Abdul Basit. Ma'am, group A.
Abdul Basit. Wait.
134, okay. Ma'am. Ma'am, I'm just waiting for the last two.
Okay. Okay, I marked you present. Okay, we will.
Ma'am.
We will. Yes.
Ma'am, this is Ma'am, this is Pranjal. I'm in group A. You haven't called my name.
I haven't called your name. Okay, Pranjal, since you appeared for the assessment, I already have your marks here, no? That's why maybe I missed out your... Okay. Is there anybody else whose name has not been called?
Ma'am, please check, ma'am, my name. MD Shahrukh Garfin.
Yes, Shahrukh Garfin, you're in group B. Yes, you have been marked.
Group C, ma'am.
Yeah, group C, yes. You have been marked present.
Okay, okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, now we will start with... this group discussion. We will start with it because already it's time. We will today start with group C, not with group A, because every time we start with group A. Today I will start with group C. Okay. We'll be the first person to start. I hope you remember your topic. Antarik, your topic is Bharat versus India. We will start with group C today. Bharat versus India. Yes, Antarik, are you there? Are you
yes,
there,
ma'am.
Antarik? Yes, we will start with you. We will start with you because we have started. We are starting with group C today first. We will start with you because you are the first member who is there in group C because Arvind Kumar Thakur is absent. So we will start with you. Okay. Bharat versus India is the topic.
Ma'am, other students are trying to say about this topic.
Who wants to start from group C? Other students means who wants to start?
Ma'am, wait, ma'am. We are just discussing about this. Just wait.
Okay, okay. I will give you 5 more minutes.
Okay, ma'am.
Because today anyway, I will not be able to finish it off. Today it's almost time. So, but I want to listen to at least one or two members so that everybody can have an idea of what, because formally the assessment will be taken next week. I will give you marks next week. But today I want to start it at least so that you people, the more you practice, you will be more confident. I will give you 5 more minutes, discuss, prepare, and then I will start with you only, Antarik. Okay.
Thank you.
At 2:45, you are supposed to start, Antarik. Not more than that. Time won't be allotted more than that.
Hello, ma'am.
Am I... Yes, Antarik, yes, you are audible. Yeah.
Okay, ma'am.
Rest of you, please mute your microphone because there are like, I can hear a lot of sound interference in between, which creates a lot of disturbance. Rest of you, mute your microphone. Only Antarik's microphone and my microphone should be on right now. Yes, Antarik, you can start.
Hello, everyone. Myself, Antarik Havladar. I am from Electronics and Communication Department. I would like to thank Madam for giving me this opportunity to say about this topic. So my topic is Bharat versus India. If I would see about this topic, then there is a huge difference between these two names, India and Bharat. The name India was given by Europeans, and I don't think it is having any meaning or something. It was just basically it was derived from Indus. Okay, but if I would concentrate on the name of Bharat, then it has huge meaning, or it has emotions, it has feelings, like it describes the culture. It describes the culture. It reflects something unlike the word India. If Europeans wouldn't have came to India and wouldn't have ruled India, then I think that our country would be named as Bharat only, and maybe in other country we may be called as Bharat and not as Indian. So if I would say Bharat means the name Bharat came from the ruler or the king Bharat who ruled this subcontinent, and maybe that's why this land was named as Bharatvarsha and also known as Bharat. Again if I will say about Bharat only, then it has more beauty, it has more culture in every part of the world. India is basically known for its culture, its religious, its unity, its democracy, and that's why India is known as an unique country, or I would say Bharat is known as an unique country, though we also always says that it is India, not as means like we called this country as India and not as Bharat, but if we like, we should practice saying Bharat and not an India, because it shows more emotions, or it should show more patriotism if we say Bharat. That's it from my side.
Okay. Antarik, before we go to the next member, I would like to tell you one thing. Do you think you have made any mistake in the beginning? Do you think from your end, do you think there is something which you missed out? Like as far as the method of GD presentation is concerned, is there anywhere where you missed out before you started? Do you think anywhere you missed out? I will definitely tell you where you made a mistake, but I wanted you people to even get an idea so that, you know, if you point out your own mistakes, you will never forget that. If I point it out, you might forget it. When you start with your GD, Antarik, even if you are given any kind of topic, whatever you are given, maybe you might be given at times confusing topics, topics like today, which I had given like a bit abstract topics. Make sure you follow all the parameters that are being said. In the beginning, you are supposed to greet everyone. You are supposed to give an introduction to the topic. Then you are supposed to start. Understood? You made a mistake in the beginning because your greeting, all those parts were not very clear. It seemed as if you suddenly started.
Ma'am, I have did, means like I have greeted everyone.
No, you have greeted. I'm saying like it seemed as if you have suddenly started. There was no introduction in the beginning. Just like, as I told you, when you start, you know, you should greet like, I'm thankful for this opportunity. I have been given this particular topic and I feel obliged that I would be able to present my views on this. And good afternoon to everyone, to the moderator, to the listeners. You should make it very concrete when you start. What I'm trying to say, you can understand what I'm saying.
Yes, ma'am, but I have said all these points.
I'm saying you have said all these points. I'm saying your presentation method, the way you presented, the concreteness was missing.
Oh, maybe, ma'am, can happen.
Yes, that voice intonation modulation, that warm. Because see, the moment you are greeting, if you, now this is something, even when we use our mother tongue, if we say namaste or namaskar, and we, with the tone, the same tone, we say namaste or namaskar, in that same voice intonation modulation tone, if we say that today I will not eat, or I have just visited your place to say you hi, hello, there should be a difference, right? When you say namaste, namaskar, good afternoon, good morning, and when you start speaking, that voice intonation modulation presentation thing should be a bit different. That's what I'm saying. Otherwise, it was fine. There was no problem in it. But when somebody is listening to you, know that concreteness, that warmth is missing. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Understood, Antarik? Okay. Otherwise, you are a good speaker. Your content was very good. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I got your point.
Today, I will not give you any marks because you people need to prepare the content that you presented, Antarik. You need to make it more. Promising. There are certain loopholes. So prepare on that. Next week, I will mark you. Today, I would listen to few so that everybody can get an hang of it. Okay, Shahrukh Arfin. Next is Shahrukh Arfin. Shahrukh Arfin, your turn. You're the next one who is supposed to speak on this topic, Bharat versus India. Shahrukh Arfin. Okay, Abid Ali. Abid Ali. Since Shahrukh Arfin is inaudible, Abid Ali is the next person. Abid Ali. Abid Ali. Moshumi. Abid Ali is also not audible. Moshumi Dhar.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Moshumi, you present your views about this topic. Let us listen to what you have to say.
Okay, so first of all, good afternoon, one and all present here. I am Moshumi Dhar from Electronics and Communication Engineering Department. As per the today's topic concerned, my topic is Bharat versus India. So as per my concern, very few countries have two names. And